Professor Dave here. Let's learn how to draw Lewis dot structures.
He knows a lot about the science stuff, Professor Dave explains.
We've learned about how ions come together to form ionic compounds, but much more interesting is the way atoms form networks of covalent bonds. In order to talk about this, we're going to have to learn how to draw Lewis dot structures. When we draw these, we will represent an atom by its chemical symbol. Here's carbon. We then draw that atom's valence electrons as dots around the atom. Carbon is 1s2, 2s2, 2p2, so that's 4 electrons in the outermost shell, which you can also tell by counting over from the left. For carbon and other small atoms, we assume that there are 4 coordination sites that can accommodate electrons or bonds, because this is how carbon can fill its octet, or its outermost shell. When we draw the valence electrons, we put 1 in each coordination site first, before pairing them up. So carbon will look like this, not like this. Elements in the same group will have similar looking Lewis dot symbols because they have the same number of valence electrons. Now, to draw a Lewis dot structure for a molecule, just draw each atom with all of its valence electrons. Unpaired electrons from 2 different atoms can come together to make covalent bonds. When that happens, instead of 2 dots, we make a line. This is a covalent bond, which always contains 2 electrons. For our purposes here, we can assume that electrons need to be paired, so a good Lewis dot structure will have all the electrons either inside covalent bonds or in lone pairs. The number of valence electrons an atom has dictates how many bonds it tends to form. Carbon likes to make 4 bonds. Nitrogen, with 5 valence electrons, likes to have 3 bonds and 1 lone pair. Oxygen likes to have 2 bonds and 2 lone pairs. And fluorine likes to have 1 bond and 3 lone pairs. When 2 atoms have 1 covalent bond between them, we call that a sigma bond. But atoms can have double or even triple bonds. Look at carbon dioxide. After we make a sigma bond between the atoms, there are still unpaired electrons. If adjacent atoms each have unpaired electrons, they can become another covalent bond. The second covalent bond in a double bond is called a pi bond. The second and third bonds in a triple bond are also pi bonds. Single covalent bonds are the longest, double bonds are a little shorter, and triple bonds are shorter still. More on these later. Sometimes an atom in a Lewis dot structure will have a formal charge. This happens if the number of electrons an atom is contributing to a Lewis dot structure is different from its typical valence. Nitrogen has 5 valence electrons, so in ammonia, where it contributes those 5, 1 per covalent bond plus the lone pair, it will be a neutral nitrogen atom. For the ammonium ion, nitrogen is now contributing 4 electrons to the Lewis dot structure, 1 per bond. That's 1 less than its typical valence, and 1 fewer negatively charged particles means the nitrogen will have a formal positive charge. That makes this a polyatomic ion. These elements want to fill their octet by having 8 electrons around them, filling the N equals 2 shell. Hydrogen is very small, so that only needs 2 to fill the N equals 1 shell. And larger atoms like phosphorus and sulfur can make 5 or 6 covalent bonds. Just draw valence electrons and start combining unpaired ones. Let's check comprehension. Thanks for watching, guys. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials, and as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.